Hey my friends, welcome to channel 48. How are you doing? Well, I'm here with one of my beautiful phones. This phone, ladies and gentlemen, is not only beautiful, it still works really nice. So in this video I want to talk about the G100H. This phone has not so much development going on. In fact, there are two guys that are creating ROMs, Nougat styled ROMs, Nougat ROMs, Android 7.12 ROMs, in the version LineageOS and in the version Resurrection. So what's up with this G100H? This G100H is for a very long time already on the ROMs created by Erin ABS and Partip. These are the two main developers of this phone. I think these guys, they also need, they can use some help from other developers. So, you know, other developers that are watching, Chrono, you know, I think if you take a look into this, probably you will be the first one to bring it to Android 8, maybe Android 9. So, you know, I have belief in you in what you did until now with the Galaxy Advance and as well the Samsung Galaxy S3 9300. Nobody burned their fingers on that phone. You did. You did a great job. So I'm very proud of you and you should be proud of yourself. So for this phone, we don't have so much development going on. So I'm, you know, just testing ROMs that were created until now. And another nice ROM that this phone has is the Resurrection ROM as well by Partip and Erin ABS. So these guys, of course, they work with a bunch of other developers. So yeah, I think, yeah, these are my friends from Indonesia. Well, I don't know if they also consider me as a friend, but I consider them as my friend and they are from Indonesia and many Indonesian people love this phone. So for the Indonesian people, I would love to see a bit more development for this phone. It would be great if suddenly somebody comes to me and say, hey Puck, I just created the Android 8 for this phone. That's gonna be like world news because there's no such thing for this phone. And somewhere I saw that Erin ABS was working on Android 8, but yo, if other developers can help these guys out too, yeah, why should you? This phone is not so the value is not so why would you? It's an old phone, but still it's a nice phone. It's a lovely phone. Many people can still have lots of fun with this phone. It has a good camera, it has a good sound system, it has a nice screen. It's just a nice phone. So yeah, development should go on because this is a nice device. Maybe not in the first world countries, the rich countries, you know, United States, Europe. But I think in the poor countries, the countries where people are happy with every smartphone they get, this is still a beautiful phone. So that's why, yeah, development should go on for this phone. What we're gonna do, we're gonna go into the recovery mode and then we're gonna install a Resurrection ROM that I modded. Okay, I modded it to be like the others that you saw in the previous video, and including the new applications to several of my phones, just to see how these applications work and if everything goes good, you know, if we don't run into problems. So yeah, as you know, I'm not putting any Google services on here. These phones, yeah, they run with applications that we get from APK Mirror, APK Pure, and of course as well from F-Droid. Okay, enough spoken. Let's get started and see what we can do with this phone.
Let's go ahead and get this thing into a recovery mode.
Okay, there we are, Antwerp. We first gonna do a wipe and I'm just gonna wipe everything except the internal storage. Just let it wipe. And I'm gonna go ahead and install the ROM now. So let's go ahead and see what this ROM is. It's called the Resurrection Pocket PC ROM, the G100H by Partip and Erin ABS and modded by Puck ROM. That is me.
I also changed the sounds, okay? So you have nice sounds going along with the with this theme. It's gonna be iOS and Pocket PC, okay? So you're gonna have two launchers, in fact. The iOS launcher from Loot & Hit and the new Pocket PC, in fact, Windows modded to kind of look as an Apple iPC, Pocket PC launcher. It works very nice, I must say. I also have it on my other phones and in fact, I really like it, you know. It's really, really nice. Looks great. So yeah, I'm also bringing it to my other phones. It's a nice, very nice desktop. Also on the S6. And for the Windows users made a Windows version. So we have, oops, sorry for that. We have a Windows version and we have an Apple version. You see that? So Apple and Windows users can be happy and see, in fact, the things they want to see in the system. But in fact, they are both the same. Only they are kind of themed a little bit different. That's all. And with the Windows version, in fact, I didn't do too much. Only the Apple version I changed around a bit to fit with the theming. The wallpaper, the icons. See that? I must still give permission for the hard drive. We have great applications installed. Radio Droid. Oh, that one is so cool. Radio Droid is the best. We are not connected to the internet, I think. That phone did not connect to internet yet. Still busy with flashing here. Radio Droid, look at it. You can set the theme to black. I'm in my history. That is not what I need. I don't want to mark like favorite.
En toen, ja, daar heb ik dan echt zo'n. Maar goed, genoeg gelul over die.
So it's really great. Radio Droid. No advertisements and crazy things like that. Okay, so we just flashed the ROM. We also need to flash a fix, and that is the back button fix. And let me see where it is. Fix Lineage OS 14. You need this fix. If you don't install this fix, then you're gonna get yourself in problems. And of course, we also need. Oh boy, I don't have it here. No. Let me see if this computer is seeing the phone. MTP. I don't see nada. Let's see if the MTP is enabled. Mount. Enable MTP. I think MTP is not working. What I see here, MTP is not reacting. Okay, no worries. We can copy the files from the desktop. So let's see what this will look like, if this will all work. I also pushed a nice little boot animation to the system. I hope it will be accepted. And there it is. And the iPair Pocket PC, IPPC, is booting up. Very lovely. And all credits for this beautiful boot animation goes to Sandros DJ. Yep. That guy is also one of my heroes, boot animation heroes. Because I remember a while ago I wanted to make this pair phone thing. And at that time I was just starting out and I didn't know anything. It was just, you know, learning. And I went to XDA and another XDA developer there also had a pair boot animation. So yeah, he's putting the thing out there for people to download. So I asked him, I said, hey, can I use this animation in my ROM? Or in a ROM that I'm, you know, theming and modding. And he said, no. He said, no, you cannot use it. I mean, like, if you put something out on XDA and you also put a download link, I mean, like, can you then forbid people to use it in a themed mod or ROM? I mean, the guy is not having any bad intentions with it. It's not like the guy is starting some store where he's gonna sell pair phones. It's just for fun, you know, and a group of the people love that fun, you know? The iCarly phone, many people love that. Just for fun, it's different. Something different, something that does not exist, that only exists in a fantasy. So then I found, you know, this one, and this guy, he's a real cool guy. He's not like, you cannot use it. He made it for people to use it. You know, I say, with every good man goes a good woman. With every good launcher goes a good ROM. When a launcher is so good and so nice and so satisfying, then it deserves to get a ROM, a custom ROM. Because most custom ROMs, they only come with the same thing. If you download Lineage OS, any version, they are all just the same, you know? And if you can change that to make it fit more with your, you know, your desires, then you should be able to do that. And then it's not hurting the system. It's making it even more wanted, thanks to that, by some people. Not all, not everybody, you know? I mean, like real nerds. I think even a real nerd would appreciate my ROMs. Because I don't just put in stupid apps or because I want to see apps. Maybe before, long time ago, when I started out, when I was still finding the applications that would let me do these things that I'm doing, so when the system boots up I don't run into errors. Because that was also a thing, eh? When I started out, when I would put these applications together that I would love to have in the system permanently installed, sometimes I would run into errors, you know, applications that would give errors the moment we get into the desktop. So I had to kick those out. For instance, it's not possible to push the Netsuka launcher version 4 to any ROM. The moment you get into the home screen, the thing crashes. Probably a real developer can do it. Because he will probably, I don't know, probably write some extra script or so for the thing to work. But if you and me gonna do it, you know, it's gonna just crash. The moment you get into the home screen, launcher has crashed, launcher has crashed, launcher has crashed. And there's nothing you can do about it. So for me, it was very necessary, mandatory, to find these applications that would allow me to do that, to push them in. And that's why I keep to these great applications that once, you know, let me do this all. I'm like a Russian. When it works good, I don't update it. I'm not gonna change it for something that I don't know. You know, little by little, sometimes I find an application that is like wow, you know, like open camera with microphone sensitivity, volume control. I mean, like that is like wow to me, you know. That beats each and every camera app that is out there. And the thing is also, you know, these guys are also so nice to make it open source, fully open source, no advertisements, no crap. That is the application that you should should be mandatory, and every custom ROM should be there. That's how I think about it, you know. Because every effect, every phone should have a camera with the audio control, sensitivity, volume control. Because most of these phones, when you make a recording, video recording, the recordings, they sound really bad. The video is nice, but the sound is totally messed up. Samsung never get it right. And with open camera, you can put that down. And probably you will come home with a better recording. One without the and boog, 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 you know, these crazy sounds. Only Samsung. And other phones probably as well. Most of these phones, they suck if it comes to, you know, recording loud music. So applications that can help to make a phone better, they count really hard for me. I like that. Same with the audio recorder that I pushed in. It's a fantastic audio recorder. Same thing, you can control the mic input. The volume control of the sound that the thing is receiving. You can set it to -3 on certain phones. There we are. Du-du-du-du. Hear that? And there it is. We arrived, peeps. And here you can see that we can choose out of the iOS launcher. So let me show you iOS first, because some of my Indonesian people, they will love the iOS start launcher very much, you know. There it is, beautiful. You see that? Amazingly beautiful. Some applications must still load at the other side. They are still loading. It's still busy. Give it a chance. Okay, there they are. See that? They all loaded. Look at that, man. Look at that. You see that? And these are not just stupid applications, huh? Take a good look. Open camera, APK mirror, APK pure. You have a control center, and I see that it's not loaded. Let me see if it works, überhaupt works. It should have been started automatically. Okay, it's already there, I think. Yes, it is. There it is. You see that? So, yeah, I think if you're gonna use iOS styled, then you're gonna put it to the bottom, okay, and not at the side. Otherwise, it's gonna, whenever you're gonna swipe, bother your experience, okay. So let me go. Yeah, I love it. Later. Let's go to the iPocket PC. Cause in fact, this is the environment that I kind of use these days. I like it very much. It let me, you know, be very creative with the phone as well. You see that? And of course, this one must be removed. Life at a glance. So yeah. In fact, I'm gonna send this launcher as well to the guys that created it. So yeah, they can also put it in the App Store. You know, and everybody can download it. Right? Because it's still their launcher. I only changed it a bit for them. Apple styled, you know? So yeah. They can put it at their website as well and share it in their own, you know, or whatever, because everything is still in here. You can still, I think, buy certain things in it. I didn't get any banners since I, you know, installed this thing. This thing is really nice. It just comes with some applications that you can install. And like here, you know, it will say, do you want to install the application? And probably if you're going to install that application, he gets a bonus, you know? But then again, I'm using my own browser, so I don't need that. And I can pin my phone to place number 3. And my messaging, I can put in the middle, place number 2, you see? Now I have everything set up here. It's very nice. I can get to all my files. I will need to give some permission. And you go to your drive, you can now get to all your files. You see that? Your downloads. And so, oh yeah, you must close it like a window. Eh? You must hit a little cross there. So yeah, that's it. Yeah, I'm happy to see that everything works. Should work now. It works. Look at that. Nice, lovely phone. So in fact, yeah, everything of the ROM, you know, it's just the same ROM. Only it was a little bit themed, you know. And I like this ROM because this ROM works nice. But don't forget to put the fix, eh? Otherwise you will have no back button. And nothing is more annoying than an Android phone without a back button. So now we have them all in style. And then we have some other phones still that need to be updated. I'm also waiting for the updated S3 ROM from Chrono. So I hope that one will arrive. In fact, he already sent me the link, but I got home very late this evening. And in fact, yeah, then we also have this phone to come. This is, of course, the Galaxy Advance. And this is also a very, very lovely phone, as you can see. Very lovely phone. Lovely, lovely, lovely. And this is also very nice ROM, I must say. It's an older ROM. It's 601. It's effect CyanogenMod. Version Janice. And this was created by APREX long time ago. And the ROM after this one was created by Chrono. And Chrono also created Oreo and even Android Pie for this phone. Eh? So all these ROMs still will come up for these phones. Because this one must also be updated. It's kind of old already. So yeah, we're going to update them all. So if you have these phones as well, stay tuned. Also still to come for you your way. That will be, of course, the beautiful S3 Mini. And there it is. Yep. The S3 Mini also needs development. There's not too much development going on, guys. So if you're a developer and you're bored and you want a new project, you want to become the king of you know, of this phone, yeah, be my guest. This is the S3 8190. It's running Android 6. I think this is the best version ever created for this phone. We do have Android 7. As well from Nova Fusion, but Nova Fusion is not, yeah, it's not, it's for more than 1 year that I did not hear from McClaw. I'm a little bit worried about Maklo. I hope everything is okay with him, you know? Because I'm missing his works. This room was by Maklo. This beautiful room that you see. Well, I modded it, it did not come this way, but still, you know, it was created by Maklo. It's like when Mercedes builds a car and, you know, you're gonna give it a great paint job. That's what this thing is, that's what I did. But it stays Mercedes. So this is, yeah, a lovely room for this phone. Look at how smooth. Everything works, camera works, phone, everything. Beautiful room, very smooth. Very nice room as well. Although it's a little bit outdated, Android 6. So we're also gonna update that one. And I think I'm gonna bring it to Nougat. We're gonna take a look, but yeah. I'm not sure. I think I'm gonna keep using this ROM because this ROM is in fact the best ROM for this phone. Really. So yeah. Or somebody should create an even better ROM and convince me that this thing can be updated. But it can run Nougat and probably it could also run Oreo. I'm not sure. But who knows what can happen to this phone still. So this is also one of the phones that will soon still come up. And then, yeah, we're gonna have some other little projects coming up. And yeah, just follow the project, subscribe to the channel, and you will find it in your mailbox whenever I upload something new. This ROM is very nice. I'm gonna play a bit with it. And I know from the past that battery life is pretty good. If you are a developer and you think you can help to upgrade the ROM or firmware for this phone, it would be you would be very welcome. You know, Parteep and ABS are now doing their thing, but it's been a while. They did not update anything, and maybe they need some help. You know, maybe they are also shy to ask. So yeah, see what you guys can do together. And who knows what will be the next ROM that will come for this phone. But for now, I will keep making beautiful desktops whenever something nice comes out. And, you know, I think it's worth it to make something nice for the phone. Then probably it will be done on the same ROM again. However, I still hope that something, a wonder might happen, that this phone will be going to a higher build of Android. And if that is gonna be the case, I will be the first one to let you know, or maybe the second one. Thank you for watching. If you think this video was cool, leave it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Until my next video.